Quick demonstration. Hello friends, and welcome back to Swift Lessons for another lead guitar tutorial. Over the last several weeks, I've been trying to think of some very easy, simple to execute tips that I've received over the years that have had a massive impact on my playing. So, one tip that has changed everything for me as a guitarist is the idea that whenever I learn a lick on the guitar, I should also be learning that lick in as many different positions and octaves as possible. So in this session, I'm going to be showing you how to expand your minor pentatonic scale into three octaves. We're going to be going over the lower extension, the common position, and also the upper extension. Then I'll show you how to play a classic blues rock lick in four different positions. Let's get started. Okay, close look at the fretboard, getting started with section one of this lesson, making sure that your lick vocabulary is consistent across the fretboard in various different octaves. In section one here, we're gonna be reviewing the A minor pentatonic scale, its common position, its lower extension, and its upper extension. Okay, so my bet is that most of you already know how to play the common position, also known as E position, of the minor pentatonic scale. In the key of A, we're going to the fifth fret, low E string. Then going up a minor third to the 8th fret. All right, then on the A string, we're gonna play 5-7. Same thing on the D string, 5-7. Same thing on the G string, 5-7. Then to the B string, 5-8. And the high E string, 5-8. That's a great safety net for lead guitar soloing, but a lot of players tend to get kind of landlocked into that position. So now let's expand it. Okay, so we have the minor pentatonic scale common position. Now we're going to go down into the lower extension. Okay, so this is going to be low E string, 3-5, 3-5 on the A. That's the lower extension of the minor pentatonic scale. And very commonly, players will descend down into that because it's a little bit more of a comfortable position than using the pinky note here on the 8th fret of the low E string. So a common movement would be just a little hammer-on on the D string, 5-7, back down to 5, slide in on the A string, 7 down to 5, down to 3, and then resolving on A, the 5th fret. So tying those two sections together, we can walk up the lower extension, slide up into the common position, and once you get to the G string, a player has a choice. They can continue on in the common position, or they can climb up higher into what we call the upper extension. So once you get to the G string, 5th fret, 7th fret, I might move into using my middle finger, then go up a whole step to the 9th fret. From here, we're gonna make a little tent shape. Okay, so that is the 9th fret G, 8th fret B, 10th fret B, then the high E string, we're gonna play 8-10. So many fantastic possibilities within that upper extension to kind of get that Albert King, Stevie Ray Vaughan kind of sound. Okay, fantastic work everybody. We have that common position down. And we've started to implement the lower extension. And we know how to climb up into the upper extension. Getting that Stevie Ray Vaughan, Albert King vibe, bending. And then snapping to the B string, 10th fret. That's a great lick for you to practice. Using some hybrid picking there for a little extra snap. Now, let's see if we can combine all of those different positions. A quick demonstration of a sequence that combines all of those positions. Okay, so 3-5, low E. 3-5. 7. 5-7. 5-7. Switching to my middle finger, 9. To the B string, 8-10. And then 8-10 on the high E. Going backward. All right, friends, to take our lead playing to the next level, it's very important that we're able to recreate sounds across the fretboard. That's our goal for today. But I want you to know that this is much, much easier if you have your scales, your intervals, and your note names memorized. Now, jumping into a blues rock phrase in four different positions, starting with the lower extension. It's gonna sound like this. Just a short phrase to get you started with this concept. The A string, 3rd fret with a little bend. Just a slight bend there. 5th fret of the low E string, your root note. Then the open E, 3, and then back to 5 with some vibrato. Okay, now let's move into the common position and play it an octave up. Okay, so that's the B string 5th fret with that slight bend. Then, one of my favorite blues guitar secrets, stacking. 7-7, D to A. Okay, so we're not running scale. This is a little bit more advanced. Okay, so 5, 7, 7. Then to the D string 5. Going to the root note, 7th fret of the D string A. Okay, so far you have. All right, now we're going to go up another octave, but stay in the common position. Okay, so that is the 8th fret high E string, bending up, then 5-5, stacking again. On that high E string to B string. 8th fret of the B, you can do a slight bend there before going to the high E string 5th fret, that root note A. Okay, so 3 different positions to practice so far. All right, now just one more. We're going to utilize that upper extension now. So it's going to be the exact same octave, same notes as before, but now played here. All right, very convenient position. So bend that 8th fret high E string, this time with the index finger. Then we're going to play the 10th fret of the B string, stack. We're going to the 9th fret G, the 8th fret B, and then go up a whole step to the root note and vibrato. My pick is alternating, down, up, down, up, down. Okay, now let's play them all in succession, the lower extension, utilizing that open E string. Okay, in the common position, an octave up. Okay, common position, an octave up from there. If you want to use your pinky, you can. Or your ring finger for a little bit of extra strength when bending. And then we have the upper extension. Okay, so 90% of guitar players, they would have just learned that lick in one specific location. For example, on the B string and high E string, and they would have played it like that regardless of what key they're playing in. But now, when you're practicing over a backing track in the key of A, it could be A minor or A major, you'll be able to move that phrase around. Congratulations, everybody. You've added a fantastic skill to your repertoire. All right, friends, thanks so much for checking out this lead guitar tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it and found it valuable. Big thanks to my supporters at patreon.com/swiftlessons. I hope you're enjoying your PDF study guide and all the other resources I've posted there. Thanks to you guys, I've got many more lessons coming up, so keep checking back. Please subscribe, please share. This is Rob at Swift Guitar Lessons in Philadelphia, saying happy picking.